Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Vintage. Thank you to everybody who left comments last week. I was talking about The Story of a Million Years by David Huddle, which is a book that we don't publish. In fact, it's not even published in the UK at all. And I'm glad that there were some people there who liked my idea of sort of paying it forward, you know, sending the book out and then somebody then passing it on to another reader, then another, and hopefully finding out what everybody thinks about it along the way. So it makes it much easier to pick a winner this week because I don't feel like I'm just picking one person. I feel like it's gonna reach more readers. So there is one person who's won, and that person is Scott Cooper. So congratulations, Scott. You will find my email address at the bottom of this video's description. Send me your postal address and I'll get the book off to you straight away. I'm here to talk to you about a different book, but this is related to an earlier blog post this year, my Christmas jumper bumper special, in which I mentioned a graphic novel, and Christian in the comments mentioned that he had read and loved Persepolis. And I thought, oh God, I read that book such a long time ago, I want to read it again. So I did. And here it is. This is Persepolis. In fact, there's Persepolis and Persepolis 2, and this volume gathers both of those together. But I read Persepolis, the first book, and it's a classic graphic novel. So if you have not read any graphic novels, there are some that I would describe as classics. So you're going to hear books like Watchmen or From Hell or Mouse or, I mean, the list goes on and on and on. But Persepolis is definitely one of them. It's one of the sort of the classics that you must read if you want to get an understanding about graphic novels. But what I was thinking was, why? Why is it such a classic when I was reading it this time? Why does it work so well? And just a bit of background. So it's written by a woman called Marjane Satrapi, and this is a look really at her Iranian childhood. And she grew up in Iran during the period in which there was the Cultural Revolution, in which that country completely changed and went from being an imperial country with an emperor and then turning into a Muslim state and women having to wear the veil. Huge, huge political and social upheaval in that country. And it happened while she was there and growing up as a girl, which of course has, it gives you your own things to deal with. And that's why she's a brilliant viewpoint, if you like, to understand what's going on in the country, because she is a fascinating character, I'm going to call her, even though she's a real person. The reason why I'm going to call her a character is because she's got such great character. She's a brilliantly funny and entertaining sort of mouthpiece or viewpoint in which to find out about this story. Her parents are Marxists, and yet she's also the great-granddaughter of the last emperor of Iran. And she is trying to work out what, you know, who she is and what she's going to grow up to be and what's important in her life at the same time as everything around her is changing. And that's why it's one of the reasons why it's so, so brilliant. The conversations that she has with her parents, the conversations that she has with her friends, the things that happen to her wider family, they all give you such an amazing insight into a very complicated political and social situation in that country. And so it's a bit like reading the works by Joe Sacco, who's another graphic novelist. He does sort of graphic reportage, and there's been so much that I've learned from his books about quite complicated political situations. So if you ever feel like you don't really understand what's going on in Israel or Eastern Europe or something like that, he does this brilliant thing of getting personal testimony from people that really helps you to understand what's going on? Why are there these deep-seated resentments between groups of people? What is the political situation there? He does it brilliantly, and it's done brilliantly in this book as well. Because it's a complicated situation, and what you get to see here is a girl trying to understand how to be the, you know, the best person that she can be, whose side she should be on in different arguments, struggling against this imposition of sort of Muslim law and order. You know, having to wear a veil, having to behave a certain way in school, having to have a completely different, I guess, belief system from what had gone before, and certainly what she was used to at home with her Marxist parents. And the book is funny. That's the other thing. It's really, really funny because she is hilarious. You'll see from some of the pictures that I'm flashing up that the artwork is very simple, black and white artwork, but you can see real character in her face and great expressions and sentences that she comes up with that genuinely make you laugh as you're reading through the book. So it's got this charm to it, which you don't often have, I think, in books that are going to deal with this kind of subject matter. The charm of a young girl with great character, you know, recounting in memoir form, I guess, what it was like growing up in that country. There's also, of course, great tenderness and sadness. There is, you know, there is war, there is death. She loses members of her family. It talks about the torture of people. under both regimes. You know, we're talking about old Iran and new Iran, and they, of course, are a people whose sort of history goes back into the, you know, the Persian Empire. And so, at one point, they're talking about, you know, events that happened 1,400 years ago. That's how deep seated some of these resentments and oppositions are between groups of people. And I'm saying all of this like it sounds terribly complicated, which it is, but it's dealt with in such a simple way that's really easy to digest. You know, I read that in an evening. You can just sit there and take it all in. And now, of course, I have the joy of Persepolis 2 to read through now, which is where she goes back to Iran after having left it. And, I, you know, that will, of course, give a unique and very different viewpoint on our country to see how it's changed since she's left. So there we go. That is Persepolis. I've done a very poor job, probably, of summarising why it's a brilliant book. And, of course, the only way to solve that is for you to go and read it. There is, of course, a film as well, which was, you know, huge, you know, was received so brilliantly and won all sorts of awards. I would, of course, counsel you to read the book first. Always, in fact. Whenever we're talking about a book being turned into a film, always try and read the book first. You know, cast it yourself. Get an idea about what it looks like in your own head, because that's way more fun and way more involving and way more, you know, you get much better feedback. Then, of course, you can go and watch the film and sort of bitch and moan about them having got the casting completely wrong, which, of course, happens a fair bit. But anyway, I have a copy of Persepolis to give away. As I say, it has Persepolis and Persepolis 2 in there. So if you're interested, please leave a comment below and I will pick one of you to win. Now, I was going to say the following week, however, and please don't start welling up or crying, this is fair warning, next week, of course, is going to be Christmas. So there will be no vlog. And then the week after that will be New Year. There will be no vlog. I will be back in 2016. So you'll have to wait a couple of weeks, but I promise I will be back, at which point I will tell you who's won that copy. Sorry to make you wait all that time. But the good news, and this will help you dry away those tears that you're so obviously shedding, 2016, we have got some amazing, amazing books coming. I am already a little bit overexcited about being able to tell you about them, but they will have to come as they come through the year. But I promise you, there are so many books that I have been lucky enough to read already, which are fantastic. And so I can't wait to tell you about them, but we're going to have to wait. So thank you to everybody who has been part of the vlog this year. We started in April and now we're at the end of the year, and it's just been brilliant. So thank you for following and subscribing. I hope to see you next year. I can't wait to tell you about more of these lovely books. But most importantly, have a brilliant, brilliant Christmas. Have a great new year. And I'll see you in January. Take care.